Hello, welcome back all of you for this session 5 model on control engineering notes, video notes. And in this we will discuss the proportional integral mode controller. This is composite control mode obtained by combining the proportional mode and the integral mode. The mathematical expression for such a composite control is as shown below. P of t is equal to Kp e of t plus Kp into Ki integration of t 0 to t e of t into dt plus p 0, where p 0 is equal to initial value of the output at time t is equal to 0. The important advantage of this control is that 1-to-1 correspondence of proportional mode is available, while the offset gets eliminated due to integral mode. The integral part of such a composite control provides a reset of the zero error output after a load change occurs. Consider the load change occurring at t is equal to t1, and due to which error varies as shown in the figure. The controller output changes suddenly by amount Vp due to the proportional action. After that, controller output changes linearly with respect to time at a rate Ap by Ti. The reset rate is defined as reciprocal of Ti, which is shown in this graph, where E is error E of t over the time, which increases at t1 vertically and horizontal. Again, the controller output P of t over the time t is shown in this graph here. In between time t1 and t2, Vp corresponds immediate rise due to proportional action. Vi shows rise in output due to integral action between times t1 and t2. The response of composite Pi control mode for reverse action is shown in the following figure. In this, error E of t over the time is shown here. Similarly, controller output P of t over time is in this graph. Here, horizontal dotted line shows the proportional action of proportional controller, and this inclined dotted line shows the integral action of the integral control. Both combined integral and proportional controller shows the continuous line of this composite mode as shown in this graph. Now, characteristics of proportional integral mode controller are as listed below. Number one, when the error is zero, the controller output is fixed at the value that integral mode had when the error went to zero. This is nothing but P of zero. Second one, when the error is not zero, proportional mode adds the correction while the integral term starts increasing or decreasing from its initial value, depending upon the reverse or direct action. Third one, it improves the steady state efficiency. Fourth one, it increases the rise time to so response becomes low. Fifth, it decreases bandwidth of the system. Sixth, it filters out the high frequency noise. Seventh, it makes the response oscillatory. Applications. Pi mode completely removes the offset problems of proportional mode. Such a mode can be used in system with the frequent or large load changes, but the process must have relatively slow changes in the load to prevent the oscillations. Next one is the proportional derivative mode or PD mode controller. This series combination of proportional and derivative controller modes is the proportional plus derivative control mode. The mathematical expression for the PD composite control is as following. P of t is equal to Kp e of t plus Kp into Kd into derivative e of t by dt plus P of 0. The behavior of such a PD control to ramp type of the input is shown in the following figure in the next slide. It shows the next slide. The ramp function of error occurs at the time t is equal to t1. The derivative mode causes a step Vd at t1, and proportional mode causes a rise of Vp equals to Vd. Means here Vd means derivative and Vp means proportional. Vp equals to Vd at the T2. This is for the direct action of proportional derivative control. This graph shows the PD mode controller. Then error Et with respect to time is derivative E of T by dt time T1 with n grams. Okay. And controller output P of T over the time is shown here. In between time T1 to T2, Vd is immediate rise due to derivative action. Vp is rise in signal due to proportional action between times T1 and T2. The below figure shows the behavior of proportional derivative control for the arbitrary load changes for reverse action. So here E of T with the plus or minus and offset of with respect to time is shown in figure. Here it is positive, again reduces and it comes negative only. This is the offset value. And here controller output is P of T over the time. Here derivative response is here, derivative response is here, and this is this inclined line towards downside is proportional response. For the reverse action, the controller output is image of the error for the proportional mode, while derivative mode causes sudden increase or decrease in the output corresponding to decrease or increase in the error. This mode cannot eliminate the offset of the proportional mode. Characteristics of proportional differential control are listed below. First one, it improves the damping and reduces the overshoot. Second one, it reduces the rise time and makes the response fast. Third, it makes the response stable very fast. Fourth, it improves the bandwidth of the system. Fifth, it cannot eliminate offset error. Sixth, it may make the noise dominant at high frequencies. Seventh, it is not very effective for lightly damping system. Eighth, it may require a relatively large capacitor while the circuit implementation. Applications. It cannot eliminate offset error of proportional mode, but it can be used to handle fast process load changes if offset error is tolerable. It is used in many industrial process control systems. This is the end of session 5 of module 1, and the last session 6 we will continue in the 6th session. That will be the completion of module 1 control engineering. Thank you all.